In this video, I'll be demonstrating how to get a picture inside of a letter. So, first thing we need to do is find a background we'd like to use. So, I'm going to use the Spider-Man background. Then from here, I need to place it. So, I'm going to click on the Move tool to place it. Next step, I'm going to go over to my Text tool. And I'm going to... So, my theme is going to be Spider-Man, so I need to put an S to start this theme. Once I have the letter, move it into place. Now, the reason my font is so big is because I just did this to practice this project. So all you would need to do is go up, change the font to what you want it to be, and then I change the size. You want to choose a font that's really thick. So Impact is always a good one to use because you can get a lot of the letter and with the image. So now that we have our image, we are actually going to move our screenshot or our background. What I mean by background is this image here behind the font or in front of the font. Okay. Now that we have this, we are going to right click on the screenshot. Then we're going to go down till we see Create Clipping Mask. When we click on this, it's going to automatically crop out everything except what we could see inside the letter. Another thing we can do to add more effect to it is we can go to our FX tool and then we can add a nice shadow behind it, so a drop shadow. So then from here, we can mess around with it a little bit and change the opacity and give it some shadow. Now, the reason it's not working right now is because I was on my image, so I need to make sure you're on your text. So now we go to FX, go to drop shadow, and now we can see that it has something behind it. And you can change it to what you want it to be, whatever you think that matches it nicely. I kind of like what they had already there, so I'm not going to make any major changes. So I'm going to press OK. Alright, so now I have my first letter. It has a nice drop shadow behind it. What do we do from here? So let's delete our background, because we do not need it any longer. And now it has a nice, it's a PNG, and it's set to go. So what we're going to do next is we're going to go to File, and then we're going to go to Export, Quick Export as PNG, and then let's call it Spider for now, and save. Saved onto our desktop. So once it's on our desktop, we open it up, it would look like this. So when you're doing this project, whatever your theme word is, you're going to do this to each letter, and each letter will have a different background. So if you have any questions with this, let me know. Find a background image, find a font, put a drop shadow behind it, save it as a PNG.